I believe that we're all born to win, but we're programmed to lose. And, you know, a mentor of mine told me about 10 years ago, you know, 98% of the population is going to be dead or dead broke by the age of 65, depending on their friends and the government for financial assistance, and 2% are actually financially free. And I always ask myself that question, like, why is that? Like, I don't understand how that works. And, you know, here's my story. It all started when I'm walking to the mailbox. I hated walking to the mailbox because there were bills there. There were invoices there. There were, you know, debt, you know, weighing down on me. And I was negative $1,100 in my bank account and $70,000 in debt. I didn't know what to do. You know, I was trying to be successful as a young entrepreneur, but I didn't know exactly what to do. And I think that, you know, all of us are in that spot sometimes where, you know, we want to have this life. We want to have this incredible life, but we don't know or have the tools or the skills to do it. And so, you know, what I had to go through is I had a learning curve. Like we all have a learning curve. And I believe that we should believe in something bigger than us. Something that has more power than us. You know, it's kind of crazy to think that a lot of people think that we're operating on an island by ourselves. But no, I mean, wealth building is a team sport. You know, we all want to have what we want to have. I mean, I think that all of us, when you boil it down to like similar goals or whatever, I believe that we all have that. And that's fun. We want to have fun in our life. We want to have freedom to do what we want to do with whoever we want to do it with, as much as we want to do it, and also fulfillment. You know, the thing is like you can have all the freedom and the fun, but you have that empty wind or that empty feeling in your stomach. You know, that's that lack of fulfillment. That's that lack of mattering and meaning in the world. And so I call that the trifecta. And I call that higher life design because I feel that and I believe that we all should have a higher life design. We should have a higher life. We should, there is a better version of ourselves out there. It's just, how do we find that better version of ourselves? Well, we do that by marching forward. There is no such thing as balance. I mean, when something is in balance, it's either not moving forward or backward. You know, I think if you want to achieve something, you got to be moving forward. And then when you're done with that, you move forward on something else. I mean, that's what I believe. And I believe that to have a higher life design, you know, we should be a better husband and a better father and a better friend or a better businessman or a better businesswoman, whatever that is. And I think that the greater that we are, the more we can serve others, the more of what we have, the more that we can give others. And so we can't give what we don't have. I believe that being a lifelong student is very important. I believe that once you've arrived, your life is over. You know, and for me, I believe that learning is the key. Learning is progress. And I feel that applying that knowledge and progressing, you know, myself or ourselves betters the world. And I believe that with our purpose in life, whether you know that purpose right now, or maybe you might know it next week or next month, the thing is that you're in pursuit of that purpose. And that I think one of the things that help us get purpose and help us get meaning is being around people of purpose, being around people of meaning, being around people of vision, that we get exposed to different ways and different stories and different people that have accomplished different things, and that inspires us. And so we take that inspiration and we let it fuel us, not make us jealous. You know, if you want to really have what you want to have, don't take what other people have and be jealous or envious. Take what they have and use that as fuel. Use that as fuel to inspire you to greater heights, whatever that is for you, whether that's spending more time with your kids, or that's traveling around the world, or building that massive business, or building schools around the world, or orphanages, or what have you. I believe that you are put on this earth to do something. And that something is waiting for you, but it takes you to be committed to that higher life design. It takes you committed to want to be that student for life, to be hungry, to soak up all that knowledge that you need, to apply that knowledge, but not just do it by yourself, to bring people along with you, because achieving something great it's great, but it's even better when you can celebrate it with your friends, with your family, with people that you love, that you did it with as a team. And so one of the ultimate things that I've learned and what I believe is that wealth building, not just in money, but in experiences in life, is a team sport.